Welcome to the virtual presentation of safe interruptions of non-driving related tasks in automated vehicles, mobile versus setup display. My name is Michael Gerber, and I have the honor to present this research in behalf of Dr. Ronald Schroeder, Dr. Xiaoming Li, and Dr. Mohamed El-Nawawi, all members of the Center for Accident Research and Road Safety Queensland and the Queensland University of Technology. Currently, we are driving vehicles still by ourselves. Research indicates that drivers are engaged in secondary tasks with increasing automation. This can lead to dangerous behavior, and therefore some non-driving related tasks are forbidden, such as the use of a mobile phone in most of the countries. Let's start from the beginning. The Society of Automotive Engineers, short SAE, has developed a standard for common understanding to describe the transition from manual driving to full automation and levels while increasing the automation in each step. In this description, the first three levels from 0 to 2 are considered as manual driving. These can include automated driving features such as advanced distance cruise control and line keeping. During these three stages, the driver performs the driving task as primary task. A secondary task is therefore considered as distraction. This will change in the future with the development of automated driving systems. They will free the driver from the driving tasks and enable so-called non-driving related tasks. But we just can't fully engage in NDRTs until we have reached the stage of full automation. We need to go through this process of conditional automation and high automation. In these, a driver needs to remain fallback ready to overtake vehicle control if the vehicle reaches a limitation of its own capabilities. The implication to remain fallback ready can be a change to a lower level, such as partial automation, which means the fallback ready driver changes its role to a driver. This fallback readiness reduces, therefore, the freedom of the non-driving related task and can be even safety critical. Our focus is therefore in level 3 conditional automation and level 4 high automation. The results we found are also important for level 5 to address further issues in full automation. This driver state transition is described in a framework from Janssen et al. It describes the transition from the non-driving related task to the driving task, which can be safety critical, and afterwards the change back to the non-driving related task. In this research, we are focused on the driver state transition from the NDRT to the driving task. Janssen et al. Are using steps to describe schematically how humans change their state. While in zero, the fallback driver is engaged in an NDRT, self-interruptions can occur during that time, or an external alert triggers the fallback. Self-interruptions in this context is a voluntary interruption of the NDRT, in contrast to an external alert is involuntary. This can cause a disengagement from the NDRT, followed by an orientation phase. After the non-driving related task is completely suspended and the physical transfer of the control is finished, the driver is able to contribute full to the driving task. However, these stages 2 to 5 are interleaved and can occur more often in the driver state transition. In this research, we focus on the self-interruption of the first step because, following the hypothesis of Schroeder and Steinberger, that an increased situation awareness leads to a reduced takeover time. In Janssen's framework, the reduced transition of the driver state transition is caused from a higher situation awareness, which reduces the orientation phase, which reduces, therefore, the interleaving time. There are important other factors included in this calculation as well, which are described in a driver state transition model from Marberger et al. However, in this research, we are focused on the self-interruption during the non-driving related task. This means for us, we are reducing the framework to an interleaving process of the NDRT and monitoring, which might end up in a voluntary disengagement. Our assumption is that the conditions of the NDRT are changing the behavior of the self-interruptions. This assumption is grounded in Wicken's SIEF model of visual attention allocation. SIEF stands for the salience, expectancy, effort, and value. The focus for this study is on salience and effort. This brings us then to the research question for our publication. How do different display devices A. affect NDRT fixations in the NDRT and B. self-interruption behavior during automated driving? To explore different NDRT conditions, we choose to change the condition of display devices and have decided to compare mobile phones, who are well integrated in our everyday life, with a novel head-up display. We used a within-subject research design and counterbalanced with the first condition as head-up display and the second condition mobile phone. As non-driving related task participants have been allowed to choose an entertaining video content from a public TV station online media library. The study took place in the high fidelity simulator of Carskuen QUT. Compared to previous study we used to simulate automated driving, real-world recorded videos and played them back in the front screens, side and back mirrors and showed the GPS route on a mobile phone in the center of the vehicle. The first condition of the head-up display was shown as a transparent fixed overlay on the center screen to mimic a windshield display. In this analysis, we used head and eye tracking to label NDRT engagement and interruptions. In the second condition, participants have not given restrictions or hints how to place their mobile phone to achieve a more realistic behavior. This condition required therefore manual annotation. Each drive took 15 minutes and started in an urban area, continued on a highway, and ended in a suburban area. In this data analysis, we have labeled 5 minutes of uneventful automated driving at the end of the highway drive before the vehicle changed to the exit lane. The label are number of non-driving related task fixations. Every time we talk about long fixations, we talk about fixations over 2 seconds. This time frame is typically used in distraction research. Duration of long NDRT fixations, number of self-interruptions, and duration of self-interruptions. We invited 42 participants, 23 male and 23 female. They aged between 20 and 62, with an average age of 32 and the standard deviation of 8.4. All participants held a valid Australian driver's license. Let's have now a look at the results. All the results on this presentation are shortened. We encourage the audience to consult the paper for more insights. At first, we are looking at the yellow graphs. The filled line shows the mobile phone condition, while the dotted indicates the head-up display condition. When we compare these, we see then that the mobile phone condition has a higher number in engagement on the non-driving related task compared to the head-up display. The mean number of NDRT fixation were in the mobile condition 16.3 with a standard deviation of 8.9, while in the HUD condition the mean value was 3 with a standard deviation of 4.49. Now we have a look at the blue graph. Again, the filled line shows the mobile phone condition while the dotted indicates the HUD. The HUD condition indicates a significantly reduced expected engagement duration on NDRTs in seconds compared to the mobile condition. The expected engagement duration of an NDRT was in the mean 18.5, with a standard deviation of 18.6 compared to the HUD 2.76, with an SD of 0.48. If we look now at the self-interruptions, the number of self-interruptions are 10.9 with a standard deviation of 7.9. In the HUD condition, the mean was 23.04 with a standard deviation of 7.04. The duration of a self-interruption took in the mobile condition 6.27 with a standard deviation of 5.36, while in the HUD condition, a self-interruption took in the mean 3.9 seconds with a standard deviation of 1.69. To summarize the results, we compare mobile versus head-up display. Long NDRT fixations are in the mobile condition higher and less in the HUD condition. A long NDRT fixation was longer in the mobile condition and shorter in the HUD condition. Self-interruptions occurred less in the mobile phone condition than in the HUD condition. And lastly, the interruption took longer in the mobile phone condition as in the HUD condition. So what do we learn about this? Self-interruptions in automated driving from the NDRT might have safety-critical benefits. Let's remember the visual allocation model SIEV. We somewhat controlled expectancy and value of the TV show and driving scene while driving the same route and let the participants choose TV shows by themselves. When we have now a look at the results, we could interpret the changes with salience and effort. Overall, the effort involved in retrieving environmental information is lower in the HUD condition, while the salience of the environmental information is higher and vice versa. Switching between NDRT and monitoring takes effort. We interpret less effort in short interruption times, which we can see in the self-interruption duration. This effort includes also physical changes such as movements as rising the head. That participants are having less interruptions in the mobile condition indicates that they are more engaged in the NDRT and the effort might be too high to interrupt it more often. This is then reflected in the fixation duration. Participants seem somehow to forget to be in automated vehicles, even if we told them before that they have fallback ready functions. This is then reflected in the number of NDRT fixation as well. Throughout the study shows that younger drivers have longer NDRT fixation durations in contrast to older drivers. Older drivers seem to interleave tasks more often. Generally, driving experience increases with drivers' age, which could indicate that experienced drivers tend to be more vigilant at the road and traffic environment. This might have implications for future attention management systems to keep drivers fallback ready. Summarized, the results indicate, as hypothesized by Schroeder et al., that the visual integration of the NDRT in the driving scene aids self-interruptions and task interleaving is attributed to the driving task. As every study, this research has limitations as well. As mentioned, we have used two different approaches to label the conditions to provide participants the freedom to have their mobile phone at a position of their own choice. The HUD or windshield display was a simple overlay instead of a three-dimensional windshield display. As Shadan Borogeni et al. Research indicates that motion influences the results of the studies like this, we haven't used motion during the video drives. We investigated how people may interact with automated vehicles in level 3 and level 4 while engaging in NDRTs, especially how drivers' discretionary self-interruption behavior during that time. We present significant differences in the frequency and duration of such interruptions that suggesting a higher likelihood of a higher situation awareness when NDRTs consumed over a HUD rather than on a mobile phone. This was self-interruptions of a non-triangulated task in automated vehicles, mobile versus head-up display. Thank you for your attention. If you have any questions, please find here our mails. We are happy to get in contact with you.